Coming up on today's show, millions of people embrace the youth climate strike movement and call for action from the highest politicians around the world who are currently ignoring climate change. The Tesla Model 3 gets a top safety pick plus award from the IIHS in the US, and the Volkswagen ID3 might just maybe be going on sale outside of Europe. These stories and more coming next. Hi, folks. Welcome back to the Weekend Roundup in the world of cleaner, greener, safer and smarter transportation. Thanks also to the Electric Auto Association for their kind sponsorship of today's show. You can find out how to accelerate the electrification of transportation in your world today at electricauto.org. We're going to start today's show with the millions of people who took action on Friday this week to strike for action on climate change, inspired by the global youth climate strike movement. Calling on political leaders around the world, those striking pled with leaders to treat the very real extinction that humans face today with the same urgency that they would treat any other global crisis, like a war. Having started my own journey towards cleaner, greener transportation because of a climate-related event in my own life when I was a teenager, I hope from the bottom of my heart that these calls are not ignored as they have been for so many years. Our time's almost up. Zero Motorcycle has released details of its 2020 lineup, and it's made the DSR Black Forest Edition, previously only available in Europe, a worldwide model. Prices have dropped across the board as well, with the entry-level Zero DS now starting at just under $11,000. The SR, meanwhile, drops to just under $15,500. And the DSR Black Forest Edition? Well, that gets all of the panniers, goodies and guards that you'd expect on any self-respecting adventure bike. The Tesla Model 3 has finally received its official crash test rating from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety in the United States, and it manages a Top Safety Pick Plus award for its exemplary performance. Managing a good rating, the latest Model 3s aced every single one of the IIHS crash tests. But I should note that Model 3s built before July 2018 lose a few points for their older style headlights, which gained an acceptable rating. The Model 3 joins the Audi e-tron on the current model year IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus list. Volocopter has completed the first urban demonstration flight for its vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. The flight took place in Stuttgart at Daimler's headquarters and, says both companies, was a demonstration of how air taxis like the Volocopter could integrate with ground-based zero-emission transportation in our cities in the not-too-distant future. While Volocopter has completed plenty of flights in the past, this is the first time that the company has showcased its vehicles in an urban setting. Tesla has confirmed that it set a new track time at the Nürburgring in Germany with its prototype Plaid Tesla Model S. At 7 minutes and 20 seconds, the Model S with Plaid mode smashed past the record set by Porsche in a Taycan earlier this year. Although it set the record, it wasn't good news all the way for Tesla, and one of its test cars actually suffered problems on the track, resulting in it needing to be towed back to the pits. There's no indication of what went wrong, and I'm not about to speculate. Daimler has confirmed that it, quote, has no plans to develop any future internal combustion engines for its vehicles. Instead, the automaker says it's going to be focusing on electric drivetrains from now on. But this doesn't mean an overnight switch to electric. The lifespan of your average internal combustion engine in an automaker is about 10 years or more, which is about the time that Daimler wants its vehicles to be all zero emission. That's around 2030. BMW has confirmed what many of us had already known or suspected for some time. The BMW i3 electric car won't be getting a replacement when it ends its current production run. When will that take place? Well, the original i3 first launched in 2013, and if we use standard auto industry production cycles, that means it's due for a replacement next year. But with 13 all-electric models promised in the main BMW brand in the next few years, the quirky, unusual i3 isn't going to be one of them. Last week, the Volkswagen ID.3 was finally revealed, and while many of you liked it, it was billed as a vehicle that would only be sold in Europe, with many other markets like the US getting its larger sibling, the 2021 ID.4. But this week, we learned that Volkswagen is seriously considering bringing the ID.3 to Canada. While Volkswagen North America believes a hatchback like the ID.3 won't be a good fit for US customers, it does seem to believe that Canadians will most certainly be interested. It may not be US bound then, but this does hint that it could be heading to more markets around the world than we first thought. Ongoing industrial action by GM-employed Union of Automotive Workers this week in Detroit grabbed plenty of attention in the news as it was all about an effort to save several facilities from closing down. But while a deal hasn't been reached yet, GM is reported to have used the promise of building an all-electric pickup truck at the Detroit Hamtramck facility as one of the bargaining chips in a compromise to end the strike. The all-electric pickup truck would enter into production in 2021 as a 2022 model year vehicle. Arcimoto, the Oregon-based electric vehicle company behind what it calls the Fun Utility Vehicle, or FUV, has begun deliveries of its Evergreen FUV. We were at the event on Thursday night in Eugene, Oregon, and we got the chance to tour the facility where the vehicles are being made. They're highway capable with a top speed of 75 miles per hour and fully crash tested. They have a city range of 102 miles, but they won't be everyone's cup of tea. They sit somewhere between a car and a motorbike, and they're designed for urban commuters. I can't wait to have a go. And now it's time for Short Shorts. Mazda has confirmed it's readying its first mass-produced electric vehicle for reveal next month at the Tokyo Motor Show. It will be a brand new model, and while we don't yet have specs, we will at the show. And the prototype mule for the same has said to be having a 35.5 kilowatt-hour battery pack. Rivian secured its future this week by receiving a massive 100,000 delivery vehicle order from one of its investors, Amazon. The order is apparently the largest single electric vehicle purchase in history, and it could see Amazon go all electric for its delivery vehicles. Tesla has begun to run out its V10 operating system for customers' cars. At the moment, the rollout is only to beta testers, but it does include the ability to watch YouTube or Netflix while you're parked, as well as a karaoke function called, you've guessed it, Karaoke. You know, just so that you can keep yourself entertained while supercharging. The 2019 Chevrolet Bolt EV has received an updated rating from the IIHS. While the previous model years of Bolt had been awarded top safety picks by the agency, this time it missed out because the tests get harder every year and the car's headlights caused it to miss the required standard for 2019 by just a smidge. A team of engineers that include former Tesla Powerwall specialists have officially launched Span.io, a fully smart electrical distribution panel that's built to allow monitoring and control of up to 32 household circuits, plus add integration for battery backup systems and photovoltaic solar panels. Volkswagen may have only just teased the ID.4 last week in Frankfurt, but new spy shots shown this week, no, we can't share them here, suggest the all-electric SUV won't be long before it's ready for market. The ID.4 will likely get its official reveal sometime next year in the US. Kia already has in production the e-Niro, but it's apparently considering electrifying one of its smaller vehicles. According to reports this week, executives are looking at making an all-electric version of the Kia Picanto, a popular supermini sold across Europe. BMW, BASF, and Samsung have launched Cobalt for Development, a program that aims to improve working conditions and end child and slave labor at cobalt mines in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Cobalt is currently widely used in EV batteries. Electric school buses paid for by Volkswagen Dieselgate settlement funds are now hitting the roads in Michigan, while at the same time, Dominion Energy in Virginia is accepting applications from school districts to help those vehicles be switched to electric. Time to say goodbye, diesel bus! A new study by the US AAA shows that the annual total cost of ownership for new cars is on the rise, with large SUVs, sedans, and pickups still the most expensive vehicles to own per annum. But it also shows that EVs are now the third most cost-effective cars to own, after small sedans and hybrids. A Swedish insurance company that ranks cars based on their ability to protect occupants in a crash, and thus then offer owners of said cars discounts, has not added a single Tesla to its list of discount-eligible cars. The crazy reason? Teslas don't crash enough for them to study passenger injuries, which honestly I think means that they should get the biggest discounts, right? When Elon Musk called a British driver pedo guy last year over a cave rescued attempt, he's now end up getting sued. Now he's claiming that the term he used doesn't mean what you might think it means. Instead, he says pedo guy is a South African slang for creepy old man, not, you know, the other thing. Musk apparently wants the case dropped. Mercedes-Benz has confirmed that it's following Audi's strategy for electric vehicle battery management, adding healthy buffers at the bottom and top of the car's battery pack that will never be used by owners. It will ultimately result in less range per charge. Volkswagen's next generation e-Golf is due to get revealed shortly, but it was spotted this week in the wild with very little camouflage. Sadly, this isn't it. Now, we can't share spy shots because you can't afford the spy shot fees, but it will have a larger battery pack, better range, and moved charge port inlet. Formula E has confirmed that it turned a profit for the 2018 year, buoyed by a massive increase in interest in the series. The previous year, it had made a $21 million loss. This is the first time it's become profitable since its inaugural season in 2014. Tesla has tweaked the end-of-quarter incentives it's been offering customers who agree to buy a car that's slightly different to the one they really want so that they can match cars in stock and match people with cars more quickly. Apparently, Tesla store staff are applying the discounts to cars in stock, matching customer specs, which meant that they were abusing the system. And those are your short shorts. There will be more next week. As we detailed earlier in the show, Tesla has been busy on the Nürburgring in Germany, setting new track times and obliterating the record set previously by Porsche in its Taycan. But this week we've heard from several different sources the suggestion that the car Porsche took around the Nürburgring to set that original record wasn't a Porsche Taycan Turbo S, but a lower performance Porsche Taycan Turbo. And say those same sources, the company is now readying the higher performance Turbo S to take on the Model S. The battle, it appears, is far from over. And finally, in the week where hundreds of thousands of young people strike for climate action, President Trump and the US EPA has officially removed California's right to set its own fuel economy standards and require automakers to build electric cars in order to sell in state. But California, along with all the other states which follow its fuel standards, and many which don't, have combined to sue the government in a 22-state action that promises to stand up to Mr. Trump's bully tactics. Given a new report this week by the EPA acknowledged that rolling back these standards would actually make it worse for everyone, I hope they succeed. We do only have one planet, after all. And on that note, it's the end of this week's show. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to help us make more videos like this, please do like, comment, and subscribe. You can send a couple of dollars our way every month through Patreon. You can send us a coffee through Ko-fi or visit our swag store and buy some of our merch. Thanks to the Electric Auto Association, as always, for sponsoring today's News Roundup show. They've been advocating and educating the world about electric vehicles since 1967. The Electric Auto Association believes the future depends on us going electric today. How true. Find out how to become an EV educator for yourself. You can discover a local monthly meetup near you or just talk to real-world EV owners about what it's like to drive on electrons by going to electricauto.org. We are members of the EAA and we are proud to support this fantastic advocacy non-profit. And before I go, I'd just like to thank everyone who helped us reach the 100,000 subscriber milestone this week. On behalf of the entire team, I'd like to thank each and every one of you. If it wasn't for your support, we wouldn't be here. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. I'll be back next week with more great content for you all to enjoy. But until then, behave yourselves and don't forget to be better, kinder, and smarter with one another. Keep evolving.